Mr. President, Prime Minister of Portugal.
It's a pleasure.
Well, come in.
Mr. Prime Minister, I'm Howard Baker.
Mr. Prime Minister, I'm Colin Powell. Nice to see you.
I'm Ken Duberstein, Mr. Prime Minister.
Hello.
Nice to see you.
And we'll have this small talk or not talk for a little bit. The three-way bus.
Wait, please, the small smile. See, I'm very pleased to be here, and thank you very much for the invitation to visit Washington.
So, please, this is your first official visit. You were here a couple of years ago. I know George Shultz has told me about your visit after his home.
Yeah.
How enjoyable it was.
And your address is in the Parliament. Still nowadays, remember the day. We hope that you could come back again.
Did Secretary Shultz bring back a date for the summit, sir?
Tonight.
Come back to change his laundry?
Are you distressed that there's no lethal aid in that contra package?
I'm not going to take any questions here. Remember until tonight.
Lights, please.
Bet you can't guess what we're going to ask.
This way, please.
Yes, you don't want an answer to that.
We'll take anything we can get. Yes. There are so many problems.
I love the more than it used to be. There's now more relations between Britain and the United States.
Right, please, thank you.
This way, please. This way, please. Thank you.
And he comes from California, I'm sorry to say.
The Prime Minister was singing your praises, Frank, in your absence of all you've done in Portugal.
That's very kind. I wish you would come up to the hill with me and sing my praises up there.
It should be much more difficult than in our parliament, but now we have a large majority. It's much easier.
Much easier. You're to be congratulated on that. I think you're doing a fantastic job.
I see the Portuguese people was a bit tired of this governmental instability, and so decided with very good sense to say it's the time to put an end to minority government. But here in the States, normally we have a president from one party and a Congress to the other side. Is it going to continue after the next election?
Well, I don't know, but we have a term in this country called gerrymandering, in which, under our constitution, every 10 years the districts from which congressmen are elected must be changed to reflect the growth and the change in population. And they have been in charge of that now for almost 50 years. And the result is those districts have turned out that even though the people will vote totally for a Republican president, yeah, we still wind up with a Democratic majority in the Congress. And I have never known what it would be like to have a Congress of my own persuasion.
Perhaps that it's the American cohabitation, as in France.
In the last election, presidential election, I think this is right.